HydroRite Residential UV Ozone Sanitizing System Operation, Maintenance, and Troubleshooting Video. This video is provided to you to better understand HydroRite and how it operates. It is highly recommended that this product be installed by a qualified technician. Installation is covered in a separate video. Before beginning, make sure to read the HydroRite System Manual carefully and completely. These manuals are included with the product. This video is designed to serve as a quick overview and does not replace or supersede the detailed installation or operation requirements set forth in the owner's manual. Pay close attention to all safety instructions, warnings, and cautions before installing the HydroRite UV03 Advanced Water Treatment System. For a free copy of the manual, please visit Hayward.com. Startup and operation. With the pool water balanced and the installation complete, HydroRite must be plugged into the GFCI protected outlet to begin operation. After powering up, the UV lamp inside the vessel will illuminate and the green power on LED on the controller should be lit. HydroRite's operation is fully automatic and requires no interaction from the user. It is designed to stay powered and active at all times and will stop sanitizing when it senses that the pool pump has turned off. When the pool water flow returns, HydroRite will automatically resume operation. The green power on LED will be on under normal operation. Even when the pool pump is not running and HydroRite shuts off its lamp, the power on LED will be lit. This red lamp or ballast LED indicator will come on when there is an issue with the lamp or ballast. It will also light if there's a problem with the connection from the ballast cable to the lamp. Note that the lamp has a defined life and will eventually need to be replaced. We will cover the UV lamp replacement later in the maintenance section of this video. The HydroRite flow over temperature interlock LED will light along with the lamp ballast LED, and the unit will shut down due to the following conditions. Flow. The LED light will light when the HydroRite senses a no-flow condition. This will happen normally whenever the pool filter pump is turned off and the flow sensor senses pool water has stopped flowing. The LED will light when it is over temperature. The HydroRite has a temperature sensor inside its enclosure and will shut down operation to protect itself if it senses very high temperatures. Note that high ambient temperatures and direct sunshine can contribute to an over temperature condition. Interlock. The LED will light indicating that the vessel cap has not been installed properly or the interlock connection is not properly made. Maintenance. HydroRite has been designed for robust performance in the harsh environmental conditions of sun, wind, and rain. Like most pool equipment, routine maintenance will help provide years of trouble-free service. While HydroRite requires very little maintenance throughout the year, inorganic and organic chemicals may deposit on the surface of the quartz sleeve, causing it to appear hazy or foggy and reducing its efficacy by lowering the germicidal UV, 254 nanometer wavelength light. Transmittance. Cleaning the sleeve should return HydroRite to previous performance. Hayward recommends that you remove the lamp and clean the sleeve every 1 to 3 months, depending on the condition of your pool's water. The sleeve may need more frequent cleaning in areas of the country that have hard water. The quartz sleeve can be manually cleaned or cleaned with an inline automatic cleaner. There is a method of automatic cleaning of the quartz sleeve. Please refer to the manual for how this is done. To remove and clean the quartz sleeve, first unplug the device from its power outlet. Caution, the UV lamp is sensitive to handling and should be allowed to fully cool before being moved. Wait at least 30 minutes after disconnecting power to begin the removal process. Next, you must shut off the circulation pump so that no water is flowing into the vessel. When you are absolutely sure that there remains no pressure inside the HydroRite vessel, you can proceed to the next step. You must drain the unit before any internal maintenance is performed. To drain, unscrew the threaded plug from the base of the vessel. Next, remove the vessel cap by unscrewing the 4 mounting screws that hold the cap to the HydroRite vessel. To remove the lamp, grasp a lamp connector at the end of the ballast cable and rotate counterclockwise, about 1/8 turn, to unlock the lamp from the vessel. Once unlocked, slowly pull the lamp straight up and away from the quartz sleeve until it clears the vessel. Do not touch the UV lamp with your bare hands. Oils from your hand can attach to the lamp surface and create hot spots during the operation and shorten lamp life. Use a soft, clean cotton cloth or cotton gloves to handle the lamp. Carefully place the lamp in a safe location. Note, If you should touch the lamp with your bare hands, it can be cleaned with a soft cotton cloth and rubbing alcohol. Grasp the two large handles on the vessel lock nut and fully unscrew the light engine counterclockwise. Using the handles on the vessel lock nut, lift the light engine straight up and out of the vessel. There is a stainless steel sleeve that surrounds the quartz sleeve, which must be removed. To remove the sleeve, pinch the end in three places while putting it away from the light engine. See adjacent diagram. Pinching the sleeve at those points will flex the surface enough to unhook itself from the light engine. The quartz sleeve will now be exposed and can be cleaned. Note that the inside of the glass sleeve is normally sealed and should never need cleaning. Carefully clean the outside of the quartz sleeve using non-abrasive cleaners, as they can scratch the high-quality glass. If lime or hard water calcium deposits are encountered, rinse the quartz sleeve with tap water, then clean with lime removal products such as Limeaway or a diluted mixture of 4 parts water to 1 part muriatic acid, 20 degrees Baum hydrochloric acid, 31.45% by weight. Always add acid to water, and do so slowly. Use appropriate eye protection and gloves when handling harsh chemicals. A lint-free cloth can be used to help wipe away deposits. After using the lime removal products, rinse and wipe the sleeve with rubbing alcohol. Completely dry the sleeve before reassembly. Carefully inspect the cleaned quartz sleeve for cracks. If any cracks in the quartz sleeve are found, the sleeve should be replaced. A broken quartz sleeve will allow water to enter the dry electrical chamber and attack the electrical components of the unit, which will cause them to fail and need to be replaced. Dispose of any broken glass in the proper waste receptacle. Broken quartz sleeve or water damage caused by broken quartz sleeves are not covered under your limited warranty. The easiest way to reinstall the stainless steel sleeve is to place it end up on the ground and lower the light engine on top of it. Guide the baffle, making sure that the three locking tabs on the light engine line up with the three slots in the sleeve. Gently push the light engine down until the sleeve snaps into place. The light engine must be oriented in a certain position for it to fully insert into the vessel. Locate the tabs for alignment before lowering into the vessel. Lower the light engine and look for the two slots on the inside top of the vessel. Now fully push the light engine down into the vessel and lock by tightening the vessel lock nut. Slowly lower the lamp down into the quartz sleeve and twist clockwise to lock. Place the vessel cap on top of the HydroRite unit and tighten the screws using a Phillips screwdriver. Do not over-tighten the screws due to the risk of cracking the cover. Turn on the circulation pump, making sure to open any valves, if applicable, that were closed. Verify that there are no leaks before powering the HydroRite. In addition to cleaning of the quartz sleeve, periodic replacement of the UV lamp is required. The high-output UV lamp in your HydroRite unit is designed to last for approximately 16,000 hours of continuous operation. If replacing the lamp, clean the quartz sleeve at the same time to minimize your maintenance efforts. Your HydroRite unit can be damaged if not properly winterized. Ice formation inside the vessel can break the glass quartz sleeve, the UV lamp on the vessel itself. Therefore, you must protect your HydroRite unit from freezing. Damage due to freezing, including the breakage of glass components, the vessel, or water damage to other components caused by freezing, is not covered under your limited warranty. During winterization, drain your UV device of all water within the vessel. Use a wet-dry vacuum if necessary. Store the sleeve, lamp, and all connectors in a manner to prevent breakage or corrosion during the winter months. Troubleshooting. The following information will help guide you through any problems you may have at time of initial installation or during operation. For additional assistance, contact your supplier or Hayward. Upon initial startup, the UV lamp will not light. The following could be the problem. Determine whether the flow over temperature interlock LED is lit. If so, resolve the issue as covered during the operation part of this video. The lamp has become disconnected from the 4-pin connector. Disconnect the power cord from the electrical outlet. Open the vessel cap and confirm the lamp connector is firmly in place. At the same time, check all exposed wires for a possible loose connection. Plug the electrical cord back into the electrical outlet only after the electrical enclosure cover has been reinstalled on the unit. Verify that the power cord is plugged into the properly functioning electrical outlet. Test the electrical outlet and make sure the GFCI has not tripped. you should confirm the availability of the same voltage as indicated on the electrical label on your HydroRite unit, 120 volts plus or minus 10%. After the unit has been operating successfully for a period of time and the UV lamp is no longer lit, the following could be the problem. Determine whether the flow over temperature interlock LED is lit. If so, resolve the issue as covered during the operation part of this video. The lamp has burned out. Replace the UV lamp. If the lamp or ballast LED light also comes on as red on the controller front, remove the dead front and look at the LED lights on the ballast. The ballast has both red and green LED lights. If the light is illuminated red, then either 1. The ballast needs replacing, or 2. The lamp or cable is not connected. If the connection to the lamp is good and the light is still red, the ballast needs to be replaced. Contact your supplier or Hayward for assistance in obtaining a new ballast. Verify that the electrical outlet where the device is plugged into has the proper voltage and the cord is securely plugged into the outlet, 120 volts plus or minus 10%. Verify that the GFCI has not tripped. To verify the operating state of the GFCI, trip the GFCI manually and reset it. The GFCI should reset. If it does not, it indicates a fault to ground in the electrical circuit or the HydroRite unit itself. Call a certified electrician to fix the problem. The HydroRite unit makes noise when operating. The following could be the problem. The HydroRite vessel is not properly attached to a firm mounting base, or the HydroRite vessel bottom plate may be cracked or damaged. There is water under the vessel cap. The following could be the problem. The quartz sleeve seal is bad, or there is a broken or cracked quartz sleeve. There are no visible bubbles in the vessel. The following could be the problem. Bubbles normally seen in the vessel are an indication that ozone is being generated. Flow rate through the venturi is too low, below 35 gallons per minute, or venturi tube is not properly installed or seated. Professional help. For professional help and service, go to Hayward.com and select Dealer Locator, which you will see directly below the Hayward logo and to the right of products. Next, provide the postal code of where the system is installed, as well as 1. Search radius, 2. Pool type, 3. Product repair and service, 4. All Hayward products. Lastly, select Submit and you will see all local Hayward authorized service centers who can assist with Hayward troubleshooting, maintenance, operation, and service. You may need to enlarge your search radius if you do not receive any results.
Continue to visit Hayward Pool Products at www.hayward.com, along with our social media sites for helpful information about your Hayward products.